Senator, would there be enough evidence to actually file charges against President Duterte regarding the Pharmally case?
Oh, definitely. Ikun talagang, I mean, I prepared something. I'm just waiting for the ombudsman to complete the investigation. But all this, I can send it to you if you like. You can read it. And it's very logical. All the connections are there. All the documentary evidence are there. All the statements on the road. You know, they make a big thing out of the fact that the Senate did not approve it. Mm-hmm. That's not true. The Senate did not vote on it. They abstained. And what really happens here is that it's still a public endeavor filled with statements under oath.
With
documents that were obtained legally. And if you use that, you have a case. Bakit hindi ginagamit yan? Para lumalabas ngayon. Oh, sinabi na namin yan, si Duque should be followed Duterte. And then, sinabi na namin, si Michael Young is involved. Bakit wala pa kaso hanggang ngayon? All these things are there, and I think it's eventually, palagi ko nininervyo sa mga taong involved dyan because bukod doon sa mga problema nila sa ICC, ito ang pinakamalaking kaso ng, it is the case of the century, the corruption century, which happened at the time when people were dying, when people were sick. They had the temerity to try and steal money from the people of this country at that time. And these are all what? Foreign nationals who are persecuting us, who are harassing us, intimidating us. Makabawi naman tayo because hindi naman ito bawi eh. This is justice. We're not talking about bawi, we're talking about justice.
Yeah. You know, and I think just to give an overall thought, I think that the bigger issue in our country, and you've been passionate about this, Senator Gordon, is the fact that when people are in power,
yes,
they literally feel untouchable. So you had a certain group, which would mean in every administration, there's always a certain group of people. They feel untouchable at that point because they're with the president, tao sila ng presidente, because the president is immune from suit at that point. So ang nangyayari, these things happen, and then the Filipino people have to pay for it. And exactly. Then charges are exactly. So this is such a common issue. I mean, there's the former administration, there's the present one. It's a cycle of feeling untouchable.
Yes, it's a cycle of corruption and untouchability. And it is a colonial hangover na takot tayo sa mga nakapangyarihan. And you know, that's why I keep citing other countries. Bakit sila, they can prosecute them, tayo hindi tayo makaprosecute. And to me, all the evidence is here, glaring at us. And yet, it's business as usual for most Filipinos. That none of my business until it bites you. Supposing ikaw yung namatayan because of this corruption. Di ba, masama ang loob mo? I was there at that time. We were working in the Red Cross with all these people who were sending to hospitals, doing vaccination. We had a girl that was in an ambulance with his dad. They could not get to a hospital for 14 hours, and we got him into a hospital. There were so many dramatic stories. And well, all of the time, these people, talagang pinapapak nila yung pera ng Pilipino. Pinanakawa nila ang tao. Talagang, this is the height of evil. And who perpetrated it? Who perpetrated it? It is the president who is now accused of killing so many people. He is an embarrassment to the country. And now, he's even now, lumalabas, sinabi na ni Duque, siya nagutos. Eh, matagal na namin sinabi yan eh. And if you look at the record of the Blue Ribbon Committee, no one was spared. I can show you all the reports. All the presidents, nilagyan namin, they must explain or they must be, cases must be filed against them. Even the chief of the Philippine National Police had to retire early. Albayalde, because of our investigation. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then the two immigration officials, they are now in jail because of the TV that we were able to capture doon sa Soler para mahuli sila na tumatanggap ng pera. And yet, pagka mga tao na ng mga paghulo na ganyan, eh, they're already exempted from prosecution. The moment we are able to prosecute these people, klaro-klaro sa taong Pilipino, na nak-prosecute natin yan, maniniwala ang tao sa gobyerno, marami nang lalabas na katotohanan dyan.
All right. On that note, I want to thank you so much for joining me today former Senate Blue Ribbon Committee Chairman Richard Gordon. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much, because I really have been, you know, biting my teeth here, biting my bit, no, so to speak, like a horse. Na ano ba ito? Ganito na lang ba habang buhay ang Pilipino? Wala na tayong magagawa. Are we so bereft of taking a position, standing our ground, and fighting for justice? That's all there is to it. If we stand our ground, there will be change in this country. If we cannot wait for the leaders to do that, the people have to do it themselves.
Thank you, sir.